गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल डियर स्टूडेंट्स. इन द लास्ट एपिसोड इन द लास्ट वीडियो आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट द नाउन प्रॉपर नाउन एंड द कॉमन नाउन कंक्रीट नाउन एंड द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट नाउन. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू something about the countable noun, mass noun and collective nouns. Students, you see it becomes very technical when we talk about countable nouns, mass nouns and collective nouns. Countable nouns, known as count nouns, can be counted by number or quantified by size. They appear in both singular and plural form. Examples include 3 puppies, 100 trees, etc. Mass nouns are also referred to as uncountable or non-count nouns. Meaning, mass nouns do not have their plural forms. They signify unbounded amounts, such as of liquids, small objects, and abstract or immeasurable concepts. For example, water, rice, and education can all be considered mass nouns. A noun is considered a mass noun when its use cannot be counted, modified, or quantified in a relevant manner. Collective nouns are a subset of count nouns because they refer to a group of countable nouns as a single collective unit. For example, there are 12 eggs in a dozen and 52 cards in a deck. Here I tell you some of the common collective nouns. There are many types of nouns that refer to units or groups in a collective sense. Here are some common examples. Just look at those. Array of magazines. Audience of one, band of brothers, batch of DVDs, bucket of water, box of chocolate, board of directors, bunch of flowers, class of students, committee of experts, department of technology, family of trees, galaxy of stars, group of fans, jury of peers, party of two, society of people, tub of water, vault of money, etc. Note that when group nouns are acting as individuals rather than a whole, it's appropriate to add or replace words to create references to the individuals. For example, you might add the word members after collectives like board or committees, or inserting players for team or students or class. So you might say board members, committee members, team players, class students, etc. Collective nouns for animal groups. Here I tell you some of the nouns used collectively for animals. They are unique in themselves. They identify a specific group of animals, be they mammals, birds or insects, like brood of chickens. When there are many chickens at a place, we use the brood. Herd of elephants, school of fish, colony of ants, hive of bees, clutch of rabbits, litter of puppies, swarm of wasps, drove of horses, nest of robins, tribe of goats, pack of wolves, flight of doves, plague of locusts, group of chimpanzees, gaggle of geese, pride of lions, yoke of oxen. So friends, these are some collective nouns used for group of animals together. Nouns in the collective class can be used in either the singular or plural form depending on the context or the sentence. For example, family is a collective noun because it refers to more than one person sharing a relationship. However, you can also use this in its plural form to refer to several families. Using collective nouns in sentences can be confusing because it is sometimes difficult to discern whether to use plural or singular verbs and pronouns. To use verbs and pronouns correctly, you have to identify whether the collective noun refers to the group working as individuals or collectively in unison. When the unit is acting in unison, it is appropriate to use the singular form. But when the members of the unit are acting as individual, it is appropriate to use plural forms of verbs and pronouns. For example, look at two or three sentences. The word, when the class is used. For example, the sentence I read: the class waits for its teacher quietly. The class waits for its teacher quietly. In this sentence, the collective noun acting as subject is the class. Now, the whole number of students in the class, they are performing an action, and that is a single action. They are acting in unison. So the verb which is used is singular and the pronoun is also singular. But when the students, all the students act differently in the same group in the class, then we have to use plural form of the verb and we will have to use the plural form of the pronoun. So the sentence becomes: the class begin their homework assignments while they wait for their teacher. The meaning of this sentence is: the class begin their homework assignments. All the students of the class begin the homework, but all of them start at different intervals. While they wait for their teacher, meaning some of them might have been doing something else, but the impression is that they are doing homework and they are waiting. The class of students are a unit but are acting as individuals. They are acting differently. They are each doing their own homework assignments. They are not doing a single assignment. They are doing their own homework assignments separately. So the verb, the form of the verb is plural. Students, in our first class about the noun, I told you about the something. I told you about some rules, or I must say some guidelines about forming plurals. The form of the actual form of the verb is in. Actual form of the noun is in singular, and those nouns that can be transformed into plural, we have to add s or es as a plural marker after the final letter of the noun. There might be some variation about that plural marker, and I have told you in detail about those plural markers. So I request you to look and listen that video again, and it will be clear for you how the singular the count nouns are made plural from the singular. For today, I have taught you about the count noun, about the mass noun and the collective noun. If you have any problem, you can ask anytime. Thank you for watching this. Thank you once again.